Hey guys, today's adventure takes place on August 5th, 11:59 p.m., 1 minute before the start of regular lobster season. Get ready, we're about to get real hazards. So if you've been following our other videos, we just finished up lobster season. We had a little bit of break in between. Regular season's coming up, and we decided for this season we wanted to do something a little bit different. Usually we get up really early, drive out there, and are sitting on the holes, or right at daybreak we can jump in, catch our limit as quick as we can. But because in regular season you can hunt the lobster at night, we decided we were going to try a little midnight picnic, so to speak. So we loaded up the boat, threw in some bean bags, some food, got some tea, all the essentials, and we headed out at evening, about 8 o'clock, got to the hole right at sunset and just kind of chilled over the hole waiting for midnight. And so as we approached at about 11:50, we started gearing up. We put on our scuba gear, our wetsuits, got all of our stuff ready, so that right as it turned midnight, we hopped in the water and started lobstering. Now, this year in the Keys, it had been really windy. It's probably the windiest I can remember, and we've been doing this for over 25 years, but the wind made it really murky. The visibility was not that great where we were gonna be diving at, and so one of the challenges that we experienced was just finding the hole. You know, it's pitch black above the water. You're jumping in the water, it's pretty much pitch black except for your little flashlight. And you're just kind of shining through, and whatever that flashlight illuminates, that's all you can see. The other thing is, because we're lobstering at night is when the lobster move. And so if you go during the day, you find a ledge, if there are lobster there, it tends to be packed. But at night, the lobster move out of these ledges, they move out of these holes, and they start walking around. And so we went to this ledge and we scouted it the day before, and you can see it's packed, it's full lobster. It probably had our entire cruise's limit. But when we went there at midnight, a lot of the lobster had moved off. There were some there, but whereas before we were expecting 36, because we have a crew of six, there was only 12. Just enough for my brother and I to get our limits. The other challenge is because during the day, you usually have your net in one hand, your tickle stick in the other hand, you go for the lobster, pretty simple, but at night, like I said, you can't see anything except for that flashlight. So we're trying to maneuver ways. I got my flashlight, my tickle stick in one hand, so trying to use the light and the stick at the same time, have the other net. Sometimes I just had to just drop the net, get the stick in one hand, light in the other, and when the lobster come out, drop my stick really quick and grab the net and try and scoop them up. It led to some interesting lobster maneuvers with these nets. It also made it rather tricky for measuring the lobster, because obviously you want to make sure you have a legal lobster and you have to have that lobster gauge on you when you're lobstering. So you have the lobster in the net, you're trying to pull it out of the net, you're trying to put the gauge on it, all the while you need a flashlight so you can see. So we're trying to like hold the flashlight in here and measure and look and see in the dark, and it's kind of tricky. That was kind of a slow start for us, but ultimately we ended up setting the flashlight on the ground because the current wasn't blasting or anything. And we eventually got a system that worked. We put the lobster down, we'd measure it, put it in the fish hotel. Once we did find the ledge, it's got interesting because after we got one or two lobster, we saw a shark. And if you've been following our other videos from the Keys Adventure, we've had a little bit of issue with sharks messing with us. So we see this shark, and Jeremy signals the shark sign, and I look at him and I'm like, okay, are we going forward? Are we going up? What are we gonna do? And we kind of have a little underwater debate via like sign language and facial expressions, all these kind of things. Eventually, we kind of concluded we were gonna push on. It's like my buddy Akash says, at the end of the day, if your trust is in Christ, you're either going to go home or you're going to go home. So what do you got to lose? So that's what we did. We pushed forward. We found some lobster, like I said, not as much as we would have expected during the day, but it was enough for my brother and I to limit out. Would we do it next year? Maybe. There were some variables that made things a little less conducive for going at midnight. The low visibility, the murky water, all that kind of stuff made it more advantageous for the lobster to move, which means the holes weren't as filled. But maybe next year, if we have a full moon and it's really bright, the lobster won't be as inclined to move, so maybe then we could take advantage of it. It'd be a little bit easier to see. Maybe we won't have to deal with the sharks then either. That would be cool. But either way, it's all fun. We came back the next morning, the rest of our crew got their limits, and then we moved on to some diving, spearfishing, the usual hazardous activities. So if you enjoyed the video, feel free to like it, comment if you have a question or an idea of something you'd like to see, share it with your friends. If you want to stay up with the latest videos as they come out, feel free to subscribe, we really appreciate it. By the way, did you like this shirt? This is the first real hazardous shirt. We partnered up with our buddy at Real Fish Outfitters and designed this shirt just for us. It is real hazardous. We will have it on the Real Hazardous website, realhazardous.com, soon. It's pretty cool. It's kind of got the stripes, sort of like Oahu. It's a little bit different, obviously, but we put the stripe pattern. We got the logo on the sleeve. We got the name. We got the name on the back. These are pretty cool. It's just like the Real Fish shirts. They protect you from the UV rays, those ultraviolet rays as they call them sometimes. And really cool, lightweight. It's really nice. If you've used the Real Fish shirts, check them out. If you like their shirts, this is the same design, just with a real hazardous pattern on it. So these will be coming out pretty soon. Keep an eye out for that. Thanks for watching.